Bonjour tout le monde, hi everyone. Aujourd'hui, nous parlons de différents niveaux compétences françaises. Today, we are going to be talking about various competence levels, les niveaux de compétences françaises, the different French competence levels that we have on exam ou bien on test française or in the French exams and in the French tests that we have dans le monde entier. In the entire world. Now, maintenant, il y a le test DELF-DAF. We have the DELF-DAF examination and the test. On a aussi TEF Canada, test d'évaluation de français pour le Canada. We also have the TEF Canada test. Aussi, on a aussi test de connaissance française. We have TCF, you understand, which is the test for your knowledge of French language. Maintenant, dans les tests, les trois tests, on utilise les niveaux, les six niveaux de compétences françaises. We make use of six different levels of French competence pour évaluer les compétences des étudiants français. Alors, we make use of these levels to actually evaluate the competence levels of French students. Maintenant, d'abord, on a le débutant. We have the very first one, which is débutant. Débutant, ça c'est A1 et A2. A1 et A2. That's the A1 and the A2. Maintenant, pour A1, on a l'utilisateur débutant. You understand? We have the very beginner user or the basic user, utilisateur de base, the basic user of a particular language. And if you are a basic user, you are meant to be able to actually speak about yourself, parler de vous-même. You understand? You talk about yourself et parler de les affaires ou bien des activités quotidiennes. You talk about the daily activities that you actually engage in. Ou bien, les environnements immédiats. Or you talk about your immediate environment. Now, for the A2, you can be able to communicate in French. You understand? In daily activities or daily topics. Les activités quotidiennes. You understand? And you can be able to exchange information. You understand? Exchange information. Partager les informations. Now, I must put this out now because for A1 and A2, a lot of people would ask me when they join our beginner programs that would I be able to speak French if I enrolled for the beginner program? Bien sûr, yes, of course, you'll be able to speak French, mais au débutant, you understand? But in the débutant class, in the beginning classes, you'll be able to speak. And how will you be able to speak? As I've said earlier, you'll be able to talk about daily activities and also talk about your environment. Mais pour la deuxième partie ou bien le deuxième niveau or the next level, the second level, ça c'est l'intermédiaire, the intermediate level, l'intermédiaire. Now, in the intermediate level, you become, as we say it in French, utilisateur indépendant. You understand? You become an independent user of the language. And we have two different levels for that level. We have the B1 and we have the B2. The B1 is B1 and the B2 is B2. Now, for the B1, you'll be able to understand, comprendre. You'll be able to understand and maintain a conversation about your daily life. You understand? But you'll also be able to give your opinions. Votre sondage. You'll be able to give your opinions about things, about issues, about topics. In the language, maybe for instance, people are talking about la politique, you understand, or la policy, they are talking about politics or policies. You'll be able to give your own opinions that, oh, perhaps this is what either you are for or against that opinion. Do you understand? Now, in this level, the B1, you are already becoming an independent user. And another word for independent user is that you're already getting a little bit at what they call it, a little bit spontaneous in the language. But when you reach the B2 level, That's indépendant utilisateur or utilisateur indépendant de. The second independent level, you will be able to have a degree of fluency and also a spontaneity in your conversations. Do you understand? Especially in regular interactions with people. People that also speak French just like you. And you'll be able to defend your opinion, you'll be able to give your point of view, and also you'll be able to negotiate. Maybe for instance, you are in a market. You understand? You'll be able to negotiate your own viewpoint. You'll be able to negotiate prices and things like that. And a thing about this is that you'll be able to apply for academic programs in France or in Canada using B2. Certificate, the B2 certificate. Ensuite, on a aussi l'utilisateur expert or utilisateur avancé, which is the advanced user level. And that starts from C1, the C1, and the C2, which is the C2 levels. In the C1 level, you'll be able to express yourself fluently and also spontaneously. And you would be able to create clear and well-structured conversations without much of hesitations. You won't really hesitate much while you are in the C1 level. You'll be speaking spontaneously. And the last one, which is the C2, that is where you become a full expert in the language. And a lot of people don't really reach this level. And you don't really need to reach this level before you become a French speaker yourself. So in this level, you'll be able to speak with precision and appropriateness, and also be fluent in your conversations. And you would also be able to use French for academic purposes and more advanced level purposes. Take for instance, lecturers that are meant to be teaching in schools, in universities. The French programs are meant to have the C2 level. Si vous avez n'importe question, if you have any question, pour moi, for me, in this levels or based on this levels, nécessitez pas à utiliser la section de commentaires de ce vidéo. Don't forget or don't hesitate to make use of the comment section under this video. Merci beaucoup. Thank you very much. À tout à l'heure. See you next time.